Next piece is My Name is Pedro. And it is based on this initiation ritual for the Roman god Mithras. So just a quick little history of our kind of what this is. So we were shuffling through a lot of ideas and got down to religion and questions like that. And Pedro was sending me references, and then it sort of connected into this Mithraism. And as it happened, my wife was working on as an architect on restoring this temple to Mithras, the Mithraeum, which is downtown London. And so, of course, it stuck in my head. And so I looked up the ritual. I came across this Nymphus ritual, and there's only little bits about the phrase of the that we know about, because it was a mystery religion. It was deliberately all the rituals were deliberately kept secret, and so all we have are these little clues of pictures people did and little snatches of text and things like that. But this particular ritual, so there are seven initiation rituals, and this one is called Nymphus, which means the male bride, and the initiate would be married ritually to Mithras. This was an all-male cult, and it was a soldier's cult. The soldiers brought it here to London and across Britain, and so they brought forth this initiate, and it was a little bit like, as far as I can tell, the concept of a priest, in that once you were married to Mithras, you were celibate. There were other levels of initiation. Perhaps that changed once you hit level 3. But for a little while, at least you were celibate. And then there are also symbols to that were in the pictures, like this cup, this idea of a lamp, and I also got little snatches of Persian poetry, because there are some theories that Mithraism comes from Persia. And so I put it together and reconstructed this ritual. And I used a Mystagogue for it, which is this sort of priest who will lead people through the mysteries, probably a higher level initiate. And I also put, theoretically, a singing statue of Mithras. We don't have any singing statues, so we have a singer standing in for Mithras as well. So that's where it comes from. Pedro, you want to talk a little about the music?
Okay. From the music, I used some influences of music from the Middle East, which I actually used before in an oratorio I wrote about the relationship between Adam and Lilith, and so I actually stole my own
that.
And a little bit of harmonic series, but that's too much information on the composers and music theory needs to like it. But writing this piece was actually very important to me because I had to write it in a completely different way. In which I was used to work, and actually I have to thank a lot my composition teacher, Julie Phillips, for the help you gave me. There's not much I have to tell you about the music.
I think it might be interesting that some people know that there's no time signature on the piece.
Yeah, also that. Since there is no time signature, I only use like dots for the pitches and the lines, just to give an idea of, okay, this event should appear should happen more or less here, and this one a little bit here, but actually the singers have a lot of freedom as to exactly when they want to do what they want.
And they're singing in relationship to each other. The freedom is there's freedom there, but you're also, they're also listening and sort of reacting to the, relationship.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh.